Hi, let's talk about the ophthalmic artery and veins. In this video, we'll discuss the branches of the ophthalmic artery and veins. The ophthalmic artery is the primary supplier of blood to the orbit, eye, and surrounding environments. The ophthalmic artery is the very first branch off of the internal carotid artery as it exits the cavernous sinus. It enters the orbit lateral to the optic nerve through the optic canal. Once it enters into the orbit, it takes a medial path. So it typically crosses superiorly over the optic nerve, but it may also cross inferiorly. And the main thrust of this vessel in the orbit is going to be found between the bellies of the superior oblique muscle, which has been cut away here, and the medial rectus muscle. The ophthalmic artery has branches that accompany and names mirror branches of the ophthalmic nerve. So for instance, there is the frontal artery, also known as the supratrochlear artery at its terminus, which has ethmoidal branches. There's also a supraorbital branch, a lacrimal branch, and many other branches. The ophthalmic artery will supply the orbit, the eye, the ethmoidal sinuses, the nasal cavity, and the skin of the forehead and surrounding the orbit. The ophthalmic veins are going to drain the orbit of blood. There are typically two, a superior ophthalmic vein and an inferior ophthalmic vein. The superior and inferior ophthalmic veins can take a common pathway through to the middle cranial fossa, or they can take separate pathways. Typically, the superior ophthalmic vein is going to traverse the superior optic fissure. The superior optic vein drains the superior contents of the orbit, inclusive of the eye, as well as the ethmoidal air cells and the superficial face and forehead. There are anastomoses of these veins, so branches of the facial vein, such as the angular vein, in which blood from the superficial face may flow into the superior ophthalmic vein. If blood may flow that direction, then infections may also follow. So infections of the superficial face may follow along these ophthalmic veins back into the cavernous sinus. So they can therefore cause a cavernous sinus thrombosis and endanger any of the contents of the sinus or its wall. So we're thinking internal carotid artery, abducens within the sinus. We also have cranial nerves 3, 4, V1, and 6 running through the walls of the sinus that can be jeopardized by that. The inferior ophthalmic vein can also connect to the deep face, so it can anastomose with the pterygoid plexus of veins, so not only can it drain superficial portions of the face, but the deep face as well. And both the superior and inferior ophthalmic veins are going to drain into the cavernous sinuses, which are lateral to the cella turcica. So we've discussed the ophthalmic artery and some of its branches, as well as the ophthalmic veins and their tributaries. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.